Hey there, how are you doing? This is Kali from Tech Fans Ears. As you know from our last Redmi Note 10 Pro video, we have installed the Droid. So after installing it, I had some issues with that, but eventually I recently last week downloaded the latest Droid from their website, and using the system updater I just selected the local file and I have manually updated. You know what, it's not that bad. This is the latest official Droid, Android 13 with the latest November 5th Android security patch. From what we can start? Well, Bootanimation. Bootanimation is simple and good. The symbol is looking like Oxygen OS, but it's fine. I liked it a lot. Features-wise, we have all the Android 13 stock features along with the dedicated customization option called personalization. They are calling it the kitchen. We have a lot of options like network monitor indicator, phase unlock, lock screen customization, status bar customization, and the list goes on. You have tons of options to customize the UI, starting from the font to the icons in the top bar. The double tap to wake up is still available. Features and customization wise, it is great. Performance wise, it is moderate. I didn't face much lag and the UI is overall smooth, just like every other Android 13. I ran GeekBench. I got the score of single core 539, multi core 1589, which is fine, I guess. The compute score is 1307. Also, I ran the straight 15 minutes stress test and it was performing really great with minimal heating. Also, I ran 3D Mark Wildlife and I got the 964. Overall, it is good. In terms of gaming, I played BGMI for half an hour and it was not that bad. In low graphics, we get a 90fps option and it stays like 60 to 80fps, or most of the time. And HD with high FPS, you get stable 25 to 30fps, which is totally playable. I didn't face any heating issue.
This is a simulation game set in a virtual world and does not represent real life. Please play in moderation, take frequent breaks, and play responsibly. Good luck, mates.
The only thing that I tell as an issue is when watching video on YouTube and increasing the volume, the brightness slightly gets high and reverts back when that UA goes back. Maybe it is somewhat HDR related, or did they make any changes in the setting? Not sure.
Do any good to attack while their shields are up.
Also, right after turning on the device, sometimes it glitches or not responds for few seconds, but that is rare. This one also passes SafetyNet and all banking apps works fine. A camera to API enabled by default, you can use Gcam. If you want to know best Gcam, watch the video which appears in the card right now. What else? I checked the DRM status. It supports Widevine L1 support. Sorry, I don't have any streaming subscription now, so I can't exactly check that. The audio quality is great. I used it with my Realme buds. It worked fine. Also, good part is we now have the option to control the volume for apps individually as we have in the Windows. That is great. In terms of battery, it has 6 hours SOT with 70% battery juice, so it is like 7 to 9 hours screen on time. The 33 watt charger took 70 to 90 minutes to fully charge. I also checked Netmonster and the 4G aggregation, which works fine. The fingerprint also works fine, there is no issue in that. What else? Well, I am actually happy with this build and its experience. Surely I can recommend anyone to try it out. In my experience in the world version, the OTA didn't work. So I did download the latest build separately and used this option to update it manually. It got successfully installed with Orange Fox recovery. The video is here. Hope you liked it, and if you want to be part of this Tech Fancy journey, you can join our Telegram group. The link is in the description of this video. Feel free to subscribe to this channel and join our Telegram group to connect with the similar minded people. So yeah, thank you for watching. Code Mato.